let's create this crocodile, with simple shapes. I drew this crocodile in GIMP. I will import this drawing in Inkscape, and vectorize it. I go to File, Import. I select the sketch, and click on Open. I click on OK. I want to resize the canvas, to match the size of my drawing. To do this, I right click, and click on Document Properties. Then I click, on the Resize to Content icon. I zoom in, by pressing Ctrl and scrolling forward. And I can pan, by pressing the middle mouse button, and drag. To be able to see both the drawing, and the artwork, I will create a new layer. I click on the Add Layer icon, and click on Add. I will place the layer below the layer with the drawing, by clicking on the Move Down in the Stack icon. I hold my mouse above layer 1, and click on the square icon. I set the layer to multiply, so I can see the layer below, and I can look through the drawing. I will also set its opacity, to about 15%. And I will lock the layer, so the drawing can't be moved. I will start by drawing the eyes, which are made of circles. I will create them, with the ellipse tool. I zoom in on the left eye. I drag, and also hold down the control key, so I get a perfect circle. Each shape you draw, can have a fill and a stroke. To give the circle a fill color, I can click on a color in the swatches panel. And to give the circle, a stroke color, you shift click on a color. Notice, the used fill color swatch, has a dot in it. And the stroke color swatch, is indicated with a larger circle line. So how do I remove the stroke? I remove the stroke, by shift clicking on the red cross. The red cross now shows the circle line. I also want a slightly different green for my fill. Although the dot and circle line make it easy to find back the used colors, I would like to have the used colors at the top, for easy access. To do this, I right click on the swatch, and choose, pin color. Now let's finish the eye. With the ellipse tool I can make the circle larger. But I prefer to do this with the select tool, because then I can drag from every corner. So I drag a corner, while holding down Ctrl, to keep the circle round. Now I press Ctrl D, to duplicate the circle. The duplicate is placed exactly on top of the original. I make the copy white, by clicking on the white swatch. Now I will make the eye smaller. To scale the circle from the center, I hold Ctrl plus Shift press down while dragging. Although the pupil is black, to see what I am doing I will temporarily choose gray. The pupil is not round, so now I will drag from the sides. To make the reflection, I will duplicate the white circle. I hold Ctrl, and drag it in place. I will now make the pupil black. I press Ctrl and scroll backward, to zoom out. Let's copy the left eye, and reuse it, for the right eye. In the layers panel we see, the eye is created with four circles. To copy them, and move them together, I will make them a group. I drag over them, to select them all. I right click on the selected items, and choose, group. In the layers panel we see, we now have a group. I can open and close the group. And I can give the group a name, by double clicking on it. I type, left eye. We see the group behaves as if it is a single object. So I will press Ctrl D, to duplicate the group. And I will place the copied group over the other eye. I will call the new group, right eye. Now I reuse the group once again, to make the nostrils. I press Ctrl D once again, to duplicate the group. The nostrils don't need the pupils and highlight, so I can remove these. To do this, I will ungroup the group. I click on the highlight, and press delete. And I also delete the pupil. The nostrils, like the scutes, are brown. So I click on the white circle, and in my swatches, I choose a brown. I right click on the swatch, and choose, pin color. Now I select the two circles, right click, and choose, group. I will scale the nostril down, and place it. I press Ctrl D, and position the other nostril. I hold Shift, and click on the other nostril, to select them both. I right click, and choose, group. I now have two groups, placed in a new group. I will call the group, nostrils. For the belly, I drag another ellipse. I click on a yellow swatch. I right click on the swatch, and choose, pin color. Finally, I make the mouth with the ellipse tool. To use the ellipse tool for scaling, drag one of the two squares. And to move the circle, drag the cross in the middle. Until now, we have only used fill colors for our circles. In the swatches panel, I can see that my circle has no stroke. To add a stroke, I shift click on a swatch. I need the stroke to be the same width, as the mouth. I click on the fill and stroke tab, and then on stroke style. A width of 0.5 mm looks right. To remove the fill color, I click on the red cross. Now the circle only has a stroke. With the ellipse tool, I can drag the little circle at the right, in two ways. If I drag and hold my mouse, outside of the circle, I can create pie charts. And when I drag while holding my mouse, inside the circle, I can create arc lines. Behind cap, I choose round cap, so that the line will be rounded at the edges. I shift click on the black swatch, to make the stroke black. In the next lecture, we will look at the rectangle tool.